I wanna be there when the people start to turn it around, when they triumph over poverty. I wanna be there when the
it's
people
almost 10
win the
a.m. in Cape Town's Langa Township. Clear skies and the placid warmth of the sun's rays are providing a jovial background at Ikhaya Lelanga as the staff swiftly put the final touches to their setup to welcome South Africa's Minister of Tourism, Mamoloko Kubayi Ngubane, to their organization. Tozamile Mambu's excitement about the tourism minister's visit is starting to show as he nervously orientates our film crew through the art demonstration he will share with the minister. Does guided tours in Langa Township will today have the prestigious task of ushering Minister Kubayi Ngubane on a tour of the Ikhaya Lelanga's workspace. Ikhaya Lelanga is a non-profit social enterprise and entrepreneurial development organization that is uplifting informal businesses in Langa into a sustainable community. Game changers that are drawing tourists to the township.
I've been coming here in Langa since also I was a child. There's also another family of mine that is here that's coming and visiting them, going here. And then I started coming as an adult also to do some business. I've been coming to doing business here in Cape Town since 2003. Before I did paintings, I was doing a lot of, you know, African jewelry, sewing and stuff like that. That is also another thing I started with. But later on, something around 2006, 2007, I started focusing mainly on paintings. And then for the past 3 years, I started living in Langa permanently, doing my art business. 2009, I did tourism studies in Port Elizabeth College, in PE College, 3 years, and I finished my studies, but still I never looked for job work or for anything in tourism. My main focus on my passion was still in art business. I wanted to develop myself into art business, you know. So I continue with my traveling up and down to the big cities, selling my art and stuff. And I started living in 2007. I lived in this industry just outside the organization, further down here, with another friend of mine. And then that's where I saw this facility, and I asked some of the people who are holding around what is going on here. Some other people were not sure exactly what is going on. Some they told me, you know, some tourism stuff or whatever going on there. Just go in here for yourself, because, you know, some other people, they cannot give you a good or full information about certain organizations sometimes if they are not directly involved or connected. You know. So I came by myself looking for an opportunity to do art business. And then fortunately Tony, he had a small craft shop that he's running here, that he is running his organization. So yeah, he gave me a small corner to display some of my art. So along the way, as we were chatting, I told him that I did tourism studies for 3 years, and I never did anything with it. So, and fortunately also at that time, I found him just recently established his intercommunity tourism agency, which he was running by himself with no one or whatever. So that's when also we started working together, managing and running that tourism, intercommunity tourism agency. And then it was late 2017 that time. From then I've been working mainly tourism and artists organization. Yeah, till now. Tourism is more about people and culture. Township, obvious. Tourists come to the township, and when they come to the township, they're not gonna buy a village painting. You know, unlike when I started doing this business, I remember like in 2007-8, you have to paint a lot of village paintings, even animals and stuff like that. The trend was more on that, you know, safari tourism like that. But we noticed a big shift in the, you know, and the more growth on the township tourism, you know. So, yeah, you know, also as an artist who is into business, also I have to focus on what is in demand so that I can make business. So basically now I specialize with more on township art. So I do townships on canvas with a paint, flat paint. I also do the 3Ds with a mixed medium. I use different types of material in doing my township. But yeah, I still do a lot of different types of images and pictures on my paintings.
There's a train that comes from Namibia and Malawi. There's a train that comes from Zambia and Zimbabwe.
The tourism minister's visit to Ikhaya Lelanga took place aptly before her department's budget vote presentation that proposed a revamped domestic tourism focus that will boost township tourism in a bid to diversify tourism offerings and experiences in South Africa.
Thank you very much. For us to be here, it's mainly to say, as the Department of Tourism, there's quite a lot of activities, a lot of entrepreneurship, there are a lot of establishments that exist out there. But we want to say, let's acknowledge them, let's see what's being done, so that we can even have a better understanding of our own sector, because some of these things happen without us. You do things, you initiate things, we hear about them, so it's best for us to come and see them. So that where we can provide support, where we're finding it's not even about only just for us to be here and saying, okay, you are doing something. If there are things that we can be able to identify to be able to support, we do our best. And one of the things that previously you didn't see a lot of activities of tourism, not in a formalized way within township. So Ekasi Township is quite critical, it's important. If we are to build an inclusive economy, we are to build an inclusive tourism, we have to do it across the value chain. It doesn't need for people to go outside where they are, outside the townships, to be able to experience a better life. They've got to be able to, within their own communities, able to do a better life. As one of the oldest townships, over 100 years now, going towards 100 years. So it's a story that we can be able to tell about our heritage. Great leaders come from here. So there is heritage roots that we could be able to utilize as our tourism. As we tell our story as South Africans, our diversity, our uniqueness, but the rich history of how we've been able to evolve becomes part of the story that is unique, that many people out there are looking to hear how we've merged out of the past that was so horrible, but becoming a united South Africa that we are today, in diversity, that we are all able to come. It's beautiful, I mean, to see that we can be able to, and I like the story, Tony, that everybody can walk around, the tourists are coming to learn firsthand about the township life, not being able to experience it, because previously it was something that it was unheard of. And that's the story we must continue to tell about South Africa of today, that is full of hope, that has potential, that we can grow. It's a sector that can help to create jobs in the country, to be able to grow. So thank you very much for being part of that story.
Ikhaya Lelanga organization serves as an intermediary to 40 emerging local entrepreneurs, including homestays, tour guides, creative, visual, and performance artists. It creates business opportunities for locals in order to build a cleaner, greener, and safer community.
I experience a lovely atmosphere, a tourism destination that sort of is out of the ordinary. It's not something that you ordinarily find, where you find a center that is able to bring quite a number of packages, you know, together. The homestays, the ambassadors, as young people who are being trained almost into becoming tour guides. Some of them are already tour guides. To be able to find the entrepreneurs that are being developed in the center. But so it's a whole mixture. That's what I like about it. It's just not responding to the issues of tourism, but it's responding to the issues of inclusivity, it's responding to the issues of youth unemployment and the young people who are on the streets. It's responding to the issue of entrepreneurship. So that's the package that excites me about being here. There are untapped markets in the country that we've not been able to fully explore, and townships are one of them. Townships and rural economies will be able to assist us, because these are the stories that most of our tourists would love to hear. These are the areas where most of our tourists would love to experience. And definitely one of the things that we'll be engaging as we move across the province is working together with the provincial government and local government to be able to say, how do we enhance what we are offering to make South Africa a destination of choice for all the tourists in the world. Sihamba ngamalahle Siveleta la kupayi Sangela tawa kuka Hey babe, what is this? Zuba malahle Zuba malahle Stimela Sihamba ngamalahle
According to the World Travel and Tourism Council, the South African tourism sector directly accounted for 2.8% of real GDP, which amounts to 139 billion rand, and this is projected to grow to 145.3 billion rand for 2019. In addition, the tourism sector's direct employment accounted for 4.2% of total employment in the South African economy in 2018, and this is projected to increase to 709,000 jobs in 2019. In her 2019-2020 budget vote presentation, Minister Kubai Ngubane stated that her department would work closely with provinces, municipalities, communities and industry to get South Africans to travel their country and grow tourism. If the minister's budget vote presentation is anything to go by, South Africa's domestic tourism economy will grow, creating a budding environment for employment and entrepreneurial opportunities. Moreover, the local and international tourists can look forward to diverse tourism offerings and experiences and entrench South Africa as a preferred destination of choice. For further information, visit the Department of Tourism website on www.tourism.gov.za.